Check this out, family.
Higher truth, question. When people die, should they go into the light? So higher seven Ruth, which is supposed to be like higher truth. You're new to the channel, yes?
Thunder Wizard has a really amazing story that was given to him by the ocean, he says. And even though it contradicts the answer he gives me, it's a really good story. So I'm going to give you guys some clips to that story, but you guys could find the link in the description like always. But first, let me go to what I believe is the key out of this matrix. Let's go.
I'd rather be here in spirit than not at all. A captain doesn't abandon ship.
Every hour you stay here makes it that much more difficult to leave.
Why are you pushing me? I've made up my mind. I'm staying here.
The cortical stimulator is working. I'm getting a weak pulse.
She's coming back.
I'll use cortisone along with the stimulator.
What was that? What happened?
What do you mean?
I saw Tuvok and Chakotay and the doctor.
Here?
No, it was different as though... as though I were looking up at them.
An hallucination like the others.
Oh, I didn't feel like the others. I didn't see myself. I was looking up at them. That's the real me, isn't it? Lying on the ground on that planet, dying. And this is the hallucination. This isn't real.
More denial. You're only making it harder on yourself.
You're trying very hard to convince me to come with you. Why is that? If what you're saying is true, why not let me come to the decision on my own?
I'm trying to spare you unnecessary pain.
My father would never act like this. He always believed I had to learn my own lessons, make my own mistakes. He never tried to shield me from life. Why would he try to shield me from death? You're not my father. I could be imagining you, but I don't think so. You have such a specific agenda. You're determined that I go with you somewhere. Who are you?
I'm trying to help you. Stop fighting me.
Are you an alien being of some kind? Is that it?
Her eyes are open.
Vital signs are responding. Blood pressure 60 over 30.
But the entity is still inhabiting her cerebral cortex, impeding your treatment.
Catherine, hang on. We're bringing you back. Just fight a little longer.
Direct synaptic stimulation might drive out the alien presence.
I was right. I heard Tuvok and Chakotay and the doctor. You're an alien. You've created all these hallucinations, haven't you?
This is what my species does. At the moment just before death, one of us comes to help you understand what's happening, to make the crossing over an occasion of joy.
And what is that?
Our matrix, where your consciousness will live. I was being truthful when I said it was a place of wonder. It can be whatever you want it to be.
Then why didn't you tell me this from the beginning? Why pretend to be my father?
Usually people are comforted to see their loved ones. It makes the crossing over a much less fearful occasion. I've done this many times, but I've never encountered someone so resistant.
Something's happened. The alien presence is getting stronger again.
Fight it, Catherine. Fight it just a little longer.
I'll have to try a Thoron pulse.
My people are telling me to fight. They're trying to save me.
They're trying out of desperation. It's hopeless.
You're the one who sounds desperate. I don't get the feeling you're trying to make me comfortable. You're only interested in my agreeing to come with you.
Because it's inevitable.
And you don't strike me as any kind of good Samaritan. You're more like a vulture, preying on people at the moment of their death when they're most vulnerable.
I've waited for you. I've been patient.
But your patience is wearing thin. What's the real reason you want me in that matrix? Somehow I don't think it has anything to do with everlasting joy.
You must go with me.
If you could force me to go, you'd have done it already. You need me to agree, don't you? I have to go voluntarily.
Wouldn't that be better than standing here in this endless debate?
Let me tell you this. We can stand here for all eternity, and I will never choose to go with you.
You're in a dangerous profession, Captain. You face death every day. There'll be another time, and I'll be waiting. Eventually, you'll come into my matrix. And you will nourish me for a long, long time.
Go back to hell, coward.
new to the channel, yes? Of course you should go into the light. What I just got through saying, if you came on late, go back and watch this after it's been archived. Watch it from the beginning and listen to the story that I tell. Because in that story, if you can internalize that story, in that story, it'll tell you everything you need to know to keep on the path to becoming infinite. But in that story, I talk about that the greatest conspiracy and the greatest lie is the lie that you are trapped here on Earth. That is a lie. The lie that there are beings of light who deceive you. That is a lie. That is a lie designed to keep you from achieving your infinity. So absolutely you should go into the light. You know why? Because the light is you. How pathetic is it to believe that there's some being out there that can bullshit you with false light and trap you with it? That is so pathetic. That you're that weak. That a person can be that weak and that easily duped. That's a lie. When a lie is that poorly constructed, and it is, it's such a poorly constructed lie. You know, that's the kind of lies that politicians create in order to obfuscate the truth. You know, they come up with such doublespeak. And people buy it. That's the worst part. People buy the bullshit that they're handed. And it frustrates me and annoys me because, you know, the truth is that you know better. You all know better. You choose to believe the bullshit because you're too afraid to step out into your true power. And you'd much rather be a victim. You'd much rather be trapped. You'd much rather be a prisoner. You know, like people who go to prison? And they spend years and years in prison and they get used to having three hots and a cot. They don't have to do anything. They don't have to do anything. They just sit there and they've got a free gym to go to and they can watch TV in the rec room and then they go and sleep on their cot and then, you know, they get fed. These people, when they come out of prison, they don't know how to function and so they commit crimes so that they can go back in prison. Why? Because they can't take care of themselves. They want somebody else to take care of them for them. And that is called being a prisoner. To believe that that there are beings outside of you that have this power is the same as that prisoner wanting to stay a prisoner. You pretend to complain about it. You pretend to want to know. Let me give you another example. You know, people who say that the exit to the Matrix is at the North Pole. I can tell you that if I believed that I was trapped in the Matrix and if I believed that the exit to the Matrix was on the physical North Pole, I would fucking get my ass to the physical North Pole. There would be nothing that would be stopping me. So the people who are complaining and will go on and on about how the North Pole has the exit to the Matrix and yet they're still sitting at home on their cell phone, driving their car, going to work, eating food, watching television, watching YouTube, they don't fucking believe that the exit to the Matrix is at the North Pole because they wouldn't be sitting at home watching YouTube and talking about it. They are so full of shit. Or, worse than that, they like being trapped. Of course you should go into the light. The fuck are you so afraid of? Anyway, I don't know you. Maybe you're not afraid, but yes, of course you should go into the light. Samantha, what are your thoughts on psychedelics and their purpose on this? What the Nagas decided they would do because they're incredibly smart. They're very crafty. They would create a series of conspiracies and lies that would keep the Manu from becoming aware of their true power, of infinity. And so they started this conspiracy, these lies, and they started to create this web of lies on a covert level, very covertly, but extremely powerfully, because the Nagas also had powers of mind persuasion. And they would use their powers of mind persuasion to vibrate in the level of the Naga DNA that was within the Manu, to convince them that they were weak and that they were trapped and that they themselves were finite beings with limited power. And the focus of this lie, this conspiracy, was to continue to bombard the minds of the Manu with these lies, with these feelings, with these vibrations, to such an extent that the Manu would keep themselves trapped. Ironically, in the place of the most power, which is this nexus point of power within the universe, that the ancestors of the Manu used to come to in order to empower themselves. And so again, as I said, the Manu have within them, they have coded secrets of knowledge. They have coded knowledge, coded within their spiritual essence, because that's the one place the Nagas cannot go. They cannot penetrate to the spiritual essence of the Manu. They can only manipulate their physical DNA. They cannot manipulate their spiritual essence. So among all of these other conscious beings and entities of in the universe, there were beings called the Nagas. And the Nagas were themselves very powerful and very wise, but they were of a much lower vibration than the Manu. And the Nagas sought to destroy the Manu as they were gestating. They sought to destroy them by infiltrating them. So they actually put like parts of their DNA into the Manu as they were gestating over millions of years. And they believed that by being able to do that and put that in their DNA, that then the Nagas would be able to control the Manu and perhaps even use them for their own purposes. The Nagas wanted to control the universe as well. And they were able to control the universe for millions of years. But as much as they tried to destroy the gestating Manu, who cannot penetrate to the spiritual essence of the Manu, they can only manipulate their physical DNA. They cannot manipulate their spiritual essence. And as I said before, the ancestors of the Manu, who were once infinite beings that controlled the universe, they encoded secrets of knowledge within the spirits of the Manu so that the only way that they could become aware of the secret knowledge is if they followed certain protocols. If they deviated from those protocols, they were not able, the coded knowledge would not be unfolded within them. It would be like they would be able to find files, and then the files would become unpacked, and then they would be able to look through the files and learn and become aware. If they did not follow certain protocols, that knowledge did not become activated. And the ancestors of the Manu did this for a reason, because they did not want their descendants to make the same mistakes they had made. Because if they gave them carte blanche power, then they feared that their descendants would make the same mistakes that they did, and that they would seek to control and potentially destroy the universe. And they took the risk that they would let their descendants destroy themselves if necessary, if what that meant was that they would be prevented from becoming fully empowered. And so they set up protocols within them that the only way that they could tap into the hidden knowledge is if they guided themselves on their own, by their own free will, if they were able to make decisions based on the desire to become spiritually evolved and to become spiritually infinite. Because they knew that if they did that, they would then be able to use that knowledge in a way that would be beneficial for all awareness and the whole universe, and it would help them go to the ultimate goal, which was then to pass out of physical being and into that transformation where they become completely infinite and they transcend all materiality and all of the other dimensions. And then instead of controlling all of the dimensions, they become one with all of the dimensions. So that is my story for you. This is what came to me as I was out swimming in the ocean this afternoon. Because I was trying to find a way to explain to you an answer in one story all of the questions that you have about yourself and why it is so important to let go of any victim mentality, why it is so important to understand that there is the most powerful way of achieving everything that you want has to be from a place of ignorance. What I mean by that is the ignorance of your true nature. Because if you knew who you truly were, there is the real possibility you could destroy yourself with that knowledge. So that's the answer to why, if we've lived multiple lifetimes, why is it that we don't remember? Because encoded within you is secret knowledge to your true infinite identity. And that power within you is so powerful that if misused, you might very well destroy yourself or destroy the universe.
Be distracted by the illusion you've created. If you want to know when the mind is silent.